Welcome to this episode of Ask the Guitar Coach. Here's the question for today. What should I look for in an electric guitar teacher? Ah, yes, the electric guitar teacher. One of the most difficult things to find, but an essential part of how to develop your playing. So let's get started. And before I get started, I will say that I know that this episode will probably not get me any new friends, because I'm probably going to be going against the grain of some of the things I'm going to tell you. So first thing, you want to make sure that the person that's going to be teaching you is not someone who is a failed rock star that decided to teach lessons because being a rock star didn't work out for him. Now, there's nothing wrong with someone who's been doing both of those things, who's playing music with his band and he's also teaching guitar. No problem with that. What I'm referring to is like bitter 40-year-olds guitar players that have tried for years to break into the music business. They didn't make it, and now they have settled, let's say, into teaching guitar lessons. Try to avoid those characters as much as possible, because they can do a lot of damage and they're really not going to help you with your goals. The problem with this group of people is that they never wanted to do this job. This job was forced upon them because they didn't manage to make it into the music business and become the rock stars they always wanted to become. Once again, there's nothing wrong with someone who is trying to break into the music business, and at the same time he's also recording for other artists, and at the same time he's also doing guitar lessons. That's perfectly fine. What I'm trying to steer you clear away from is the bitter people the bitter guitar players that never made it to rock stardom and they had to settle into teaching people guitar. So let's move to the next thing. Now, the second thing you need to check out in a prospective electric guitar teacher is basically your ability to communicate. Now, when you ask him something, does he understand what you're talking about? When he gives you an explanation, do you understand what he's talking about? Basically, are you guys on the same wavelength, or does it seem very difficult to communicate? Difficult to communicate with difficulty of the materials he's going to give you is totally different things, okay? Don't think that just because he gives you difficult things to practice, you cannot communicate. But if he explains something to you in what he feels is a very clear way and you're just not understanding half of it, then you might have an understanding problem with this specific teacher. Moving on to number three. His professional qualifications, but as a teacher, not as a performer. Which means, does he have any teaching credentials? Does he have any teaching certificates? Has he studied in a university or in a music conservatory? Are these things indispensable? Not really, but it's a good sign if he does have a few of those, because that means that he has been taught how to teach, and that's a very important thing. Many players are very good guitar players, but they're lousy teachers because they don't know how to explain things in a way that a beginner or intermediate player would understand. However, if those people have studied if a guitar player has studied in a university, especially if he has completed a degree, and even better, some kind of teaching certification or degree, then it's certain that he has been taught how to teach those materials. And that's a very, very good thing. The next thing to pay attention to and to actually investigate when you're checking out a new guitar teacher is his actual students. Does he have any good students? Does he have any students that have developed to be really, really good players? However, you need to be careful of this element, because several teachers will only promote one of their students. So someone who has 100 students and he has one exemplary student who has developed very, very well and he's an excellent player will only be promoting this student. There's nothing wrong with that because this is his best student and he's trying to promote his best work. However, there is a rule here that you need to kind of know so that you can help you make up your mind. If you have a music teacher with one really good student, very maybe even famous student, that means that this was a talented student. If you have a music, a guitar teacher with several advanced and very well-developed students, that means it's a talented teacher. Let me say this again to clarify. If there's only one student that has exemplary, that means that the student was very talented. However, if this teacher has created many advanced and exemplary students, then it's the teacher that is doing a good job. So you need to find someone who has several guitar students that have developed to be really, really good players. And finally, number five, the last element, but some would say, and I would be tempted to agree, probably one of the most important ones. And it has to do with goals. Is the teacher willing to develop a practice and teaching schedule that's going to fine-tune to your own goals and your own musical and guitar ambitions? That's a very, very important element because several teachers have just one way of teaching and they do this cookie cutter thing for all their students. And this is not what's going to help you. You need someone who's going to listen to you in the beginning when you first start to work together. He's going to be very clear about understanding your own musical goals and guitar ambitions, and then he's going to develop a program to help you get there. Now, let me make this very, very clear, because here's a point where many students get confused. What I'm talking about is that you will explain to him your goals, and he will create the program to get you there. Under no circumstances does this mean that you, the student, will create the program. But it is your responsibility to communicate your goals to the instructor, and then it's his job and his responsibility to create a program to get you there. But many times this is confusing because many students will say, well, I want to practice this, and I want to practice this, and I want to practice this technique, and that's not an efficient way of becoming better on guitar. What's an efficient way is to explain to your teacher what you want to achieve, the end result, and then he will create a custom-made program for you that will help you get there. So there you have it. Five things that you need to look out for when you're trying to find a guitar teacher or a guitar coach. I would strongly suggest you review this video and you pay attention to all five of those things. Most of them are absolutely essential. Maybe the thing about having a degree maybe is not absolutely essential, but it's still going to be helpful. But if you follow these guidelines and if you pay attention to those five elements, it will definitely help you to get the best guitar teacher that you can get, and it's going to help you reach your musical goals. So I hope this was helpful. Thanks for tuning in for this video, and I will see you on the next episode of Ask the Guitar Coach.